This is All India Radio. In the program Spotlight, now we bring you a discussion on Prime Minister's Mann Ki Baat. The participants are Amitabh Sinha, political analyst, and Chetan Chauhan, journalist.
Today we are discussing Prime Minister's talk on Mann Ki Baat, where he has emphasized on removing the vaccination hesitancy that has been viewed in large parts of the country. Amitabh ji, first of all, Prime Minister today elaborated on how the people, especially in rural areas, appear to be hesitant in getting themselves vaccinated against COVID-19. And in some areas, there was this data that people who are more than 60 also, they are not coming forward for vaccination, even after repeated requests by the state governments, Anganwadi workers, ASHA workers. So how important is the PM's call to get vaccinated in a fight against COVID?
Chetan, this is a major area of concern for the government of India, even Prime Minister Vajpayee, the hesitancy to take corona vaccine. Prime Minister himself in his address to the nation has said that lots of opposition parties made all the efforts to confuse people about the vaccine. Now, the government is taking all the efforts and even the Prime Minister is appealing directly to the people. And everybody knows that Prime Minister's appeal has a lot of impact. That's why Prime Minister today talked to some villagers in Dularia district in Baitul, Madhya Pradesh. And he talked about lots of self-help groups who are doing wonderful jobs in rural sector, rural areas to show that people take vaccine. They are doing all sorts of work. So that was the prime area of concern and prime focus of Prime Minister's today's message, that come out, leave this hesitancy. And he praised all the members of civil society and organizations working at tribal and village level who are doing a wonderful job to create awareness about this vaccine.
Prime Minister rightly said that there is a lot of rumors are being spread about it, and earlier he had accused the opposition parties of creating this sort of rumors. Some of the political leaders have also said that they will not take the vaccine. And the Prime Minister had said that this is a vaccine of scientists. This is a vaccine against COVID. So a lot of hesitancy was there and political parties. But Amitabh, government since June 21st, when the central government decided that they will start to launch this free vaccination for all, given a lot of emphasis in vaccination, the record, more than 8 million vaccines were administered to people in one day, which is a sort of a record across the world. So this new focus on vaccination, which the government of India has put on from June 21st, what do you have to say about it?
This is the awareness campaign that government of India has launched. Even all the ministers, even Prime Minister in all his speeches, all his address to the nation, all his meetings, Prime Minister is repeatedly focusing on vaccination and creating awareness about vaccination. And one, two, three things, Chetan, I want to point out that today's Mann Ki Baat, when he was talking to Sri Rajesh from Dularia village in district Baitul, Madhya Pradesh, he asked Rajesh whether the people of the village were misled about this vaccine. That guy replied that out of 462 men and 332 women in the village, all were misled and all were apprehensive of taking medicines. That's why Prime Minister praised the local level organizations, self-help groups and all the other civil society members who were in the forefront of creating awareness at village level, panchayat level. And that is the prime reason why the people have started taking vaccination. And even PM who addressed yesterday at Ayodhya Development Board meeting, PM mentioned in the last 6 days, the number of vaccination has surpassed all the records. And that is why PM was proud to announce that it has the last 6 days vaccination was far more than many of the bigger countries of West and America.
He emphasized that Prime Minister also said that about 5.13% of the country's population, considering that we have 1.3 billion people, have been vaccinated in the last 5 months, because it started from January 16th, the vaccination. And in the last 5 days, if you see, at least 40 million people have got vaccination, 35 to 40 million is a huge number. But still, the hesitancy which the Prime Minister has rightly focused is a real issue. Scientists have also said, repeatedly people across the world have said, but why is there this hesitancy in people for getting vaccinated?
First and foremost thing that the government repeatedly highlighted, that the rumors spread by the allegations spread by the opposition parties repeatedly. When the vaccine was first announced by the government, Prime Minister Modi himself and the two companies, Serum India and Covaxin, were announced, we will not take this vaccine. And now the same leaders are taking the vaccine and they are coming forward to take the vaccine. And today's Mann Ki Baat, Prime Minister, while talking to some villagers in Baitul district, Dharalua village, the guy has said there was so much rumors. The rumors like, did it developing fever after taking the vaccine, the fever leading to other ailments, and the rumor that spread to the extent that it leads to a person's death. These type of rumors have created vaccine hesitancy. This is the main area of concern of the government. That is why the Prime Minister is repeatedly focusing on creating awareness about taking vaccination. These allegations, and when the government of India is taking some step, they are again making counter allegation. Now finally all the speculations and all the allegations came to rest when Prime Minister announced that the government of India will undertake 100% vaccination, and that is free vaccination to all the people of the country who want vaccination. And Chetan, that was the game changer, I think. And after that, all the focus is on creating awareness. Even Prime Minister today in his Mann Ki Baat has focused that there is district in Bandipora in Kashmir, and where people of village Vyans together themselves set a target of 100% vaccine, and they have achieved it. And today in this village of Kashmir, all persons above the age of 18 have taken the vaccine. PM also informed the country through his Mann Ki Baat that three villages in Nagaland also where people have been vaccinated 100%. So the message of awareness, the message of taking vaccine is going round to each and every nook and corner of the country, be it a remotest area, be it a hilly village, be it a remote poor village. I think this message has gone down well, and government of India is leaving no stone unturned, Chetan, to ensure that this vaccine hesitancy goes. Even the opposition parties and the leaders who are speaking against it are silent. I think the days to come, the target of the government that by December, the first vaccination will be given to all the people of India, the clinical trial on for the children. I think by December, all the adult population above 18 will be given first dose of vaccine, and most of them will be given a second dose of vaccine. And when there are any threats of third wave, then these two doses of vaccinations will ensure that we suffer very, very less.
Prime Minister also in his Mann Ki Baat spoke about that he is really grateful to doctors and health workers who have led the fight against coronavirus despite all the hardship they faced. It is more than a year since the outbreak pandemic started, but the health workers, the doctors have worked around the clock, especially during the two waves, to provide maximum relief to the people. He rightly said so. What about the broader message when the Prime Minister thanked all the doctors for the fight against coronavirus?
Prime Minister has already said that the vaccination process, when they first decided to give vaccines to the corona warriors, the frontline workers and the doctors and nurses, this decision was because when the corona strikes, they are well equipped to fight the corona. When these frontline workers, when these corona warriors, when these doctors are themselves not vaccinated, how come they will without fearlessly work in the field? They work in the hospitals to cure other people. I think many of the doctors have died. We pray for them. We pray for their families. May their soul rest in peace, and their families are given all the help that we can give, the government can give. But Prime Minister has ensured that even after that, those doctors working reports of violence against doctors and frontline workers in some parts of the country, and the message was gone from center. The Home Secretary wrote to the states, and the Cabinet Secretary wrote to the chief secretaries to ensure that not a single frontline workers are attacked. Any violence should take place against that, and take all serious coercive action, penal action against those people attacking doctors or frontline workers. I think that has reduced that, and the real tribute of Prime Minister is towards his doctors, that he is always there for them, he is always praising them and boosting their morale so that they can go out in the field, go out in the hospital and take care of those who are suffering from corona. I think the second wave is slowly subsiding. I think that is a great relief for the government, and now they are fully focused on second wave, on the entire process of vaccination.
Prime Minister also spoke to Praveen Jadhav, an archer from Maharashtra who is participating in Tokyo Olympics. Praveen is from Satara district and outstanding archer. His parents work as laborers, and now game changer for his life that he is participating in Tokyo Olympics. The Prime Minister also expressed his condolences on the demise of a legendary Milkha Singh, and also said that we start the campaign on Cheer for India social media for Tokyo Olympics, so that India can perform very well. Though the COVID Olympics is taking place in COVID times, there will be a lot of restrictions on players, and it will be a totally a different mental strength which the players will have to show. Amitabh, message to Olympians of India who are participating in the Tokyo Olympics. Is it a message for only for the Olympics, or do you think he's also giving a bigger message to the rest of the people of the country?
Chetan, this is a far, far bigger message than Olympics. Indians are very passionate about cricket. Indians are very passionate about their sports person. They worship their sports persons who perform reasonable well at international level. We literally case of idol worship in India. And Prime Minister knows that India lags far behind in the sports arena in the world. And that's why this government, when the Prime Minister Modi took charge, he started TOPS program, Top of the Podium scheme. Then the government selects many sports athletes belonging to different categories and promote them, fund them, 100% training for them. And he mentioned a lot of sports persons who are from poor families, who are from tribal areas, who are from remote areas, who don't have many of the facilities that we get in the city. And that's why he has mentioned all the sports persons who are participating in the Olympics about raising their background and how they performed in those backgrounds and came to the national level. And now they are going to Tokyo to participate in the Olympics. I think this is the message given to all the Indians that irrespective of the background, irrespective of the place where they live, if they can perform well, the government of India is ready to help them and send them to all the international area with 100% financial backing. The government of India will take care of their coaching. Government of India will take care of their all-round development. I think this was the message Prime Minister was trying to give.
I also think the Prime Minister was also trying to tell the people of the country that, see, these sports people who have trained in these difficult times, and they will be performing in Olympics in the most difficult times when there will be nobody in the stadium. So for these people, the sports people are doing so much. So we can also do something by getting ourselves vaccinated and help in the fight against COVID. But he also said something on the arrival of the monsoon. The monsoon arrived a little early. There was good rainfall till mid-June, though it has slightly slowed down. But he has said this is also an opportunity to grow trees, especially the medicinal plants, because it helps pharma industry as well as the country as a whole, because the wind cover improved. So on the arrival of the monsoon, what you will say, Mita?
PM knows that arrival of monsoon brings a lot of miseries, but it also helps to fill our reservoirs as well. And that's why Prime Minister, by addressing to the entire country, and in his Mann Ki Baat, he addresses all the people of the country, be it in rural areas, be it in urban areas. I think his main focus was to go back to traditional method of water conservation, which is called Chalkhal, that is in Hilly Village. And he knows water is scarce, and we have heard a lot about the another war will be fought over water. I think issue of water conservation and the issue of, I think, how the huge water crisis that is looming large over the country has taken a lot of pain, the interlinking of rivers so that the rivers never dried off. Now he is talking about water conservation, this is Mann Ki Baat. The traditional method of water conservation in hilly areas of India, in rural areas of India, I think that is unparalleled and unmatched. Even in ancient times, the Indians were never, even in rural areas, deserts, we were far ahead of other countries. We set example of water conservation. I think Prime Minister is focusing on that and taking cue from that. Water, trees, PM has said, if farmers will get, when they work for water conservation, plant trees in the burns of their fields, and these two, the water trees, that will fetch them money. And that is what Prime Minister is trying to connect. Conserve water, plant trees on their farming land, on their burns of farming, and now these two will help to earn them money. And villagers are slowly getting recognized far and wide, and many villagers are doing this, and they are getting good support from the government on this issue as well. I think Prime Minister has created awareness on this issue also, or by his address to the people through Mann Ki Baat.
The Prime Minister has raised are extremely important, from vaccination to Tokyo Olympics to monsoon, thanking the doctors, and he has tried to connect with the people, trying to assure them that there are enough vaccines which the government is procuring. By December, almost everybody above 18 will be vaccinated. We also expect that by September or October, vaccination for 12 plus will also be available in the market by maybe December. So, and early next year for children also, the vaccines will be available. But hesitancy, which the Prime Minister's main focus was today in his Mann Ki Baat, but we have seen in the last 1 month or so, a large number of people are coming forward to get themselves vaccinated, because indication is from the repeated demand of the state governments to get the vaccine. They are saying there is a vaccine shortage. The vaccine shortage would be there when there is a demand. So we can see that in the last 15-20 days, 1 month, the demand has increased. And hopefully in the next few months, with enough vaccines, a large number of population will get vaccinated, the herd immunity will improve, and our fight against COVID will also improve a lot. With that, Amitabh, thanks a lot.
Thanks, Shabir.
You were listening to our discussion on Prime Minister's Mann Ki Baat. The participants were Amitabh Sinha, political analyst, and Chetan Chauhan, journalist. This program was produced and presented by the News Services Division of All India Radio. You can listen to it on our mobile app, News on AIR. This program is also available on our YouTube channel, News on AIR Official. You may email your opinion about this program at airnsdtalks@gmail.com.